I'm Elaine Reyes in Rio de Janeiro. Bolsa Família was launched in 2004 as a program for the poorest in Brazil. Loosely translated as family scholarship, the program was designed to eliminate extreme poverty and bring millions of Brazilians into the middle class. The program has simple rules. Families receive a monthly sum from the government if they can prove they've kept their children in school and sent them to clinics for regular checkups. 10 years later, Bolsa Família has been credited with cutting Brazil's extreme poverty in half. I sat down with Brazilian Minister Teresa Campelo to discuss a groundbreaking program she oversees. Minister, Bolsa Família is more than 10 years old. What about it makes you the proudest?
Nós temos 10 anos. Então, nada que nós estamos fazendo agora é mais debate ideológico.
It's been 10 years, and now we're able to show results, to show that Bolsa Família is no longer up for ideological debate. The biggest result has been helping reduce infant mortality. More than half our children who died from malnutrition and diarrhea, both diseases of poverty, have stopped dying thanks to Bolsa Família. And we've been able to prove that. I think the other big result that has transformed Brazil is the impact it's had on education. Children on Bolsa Família are doing better in school, their attendance is up, and their dropout rate is down. And when they get to middle school, they do better than others. So we're changing the educational trajectory of the poor in Brazil, and that's going to help us have a better future.
Educacional dos pobres no Brasil, e é isso que vai nos ajudar a ter futuro melhor, todos.
You know, this program reaches some 50 million people, but, you know, inequality still exists in Brazil, and recent protests show that the population is not entirely content. So how do you respond to that?
Nenhum programa sozinho consegue dar conta de 500 anos de exclusão e de desigualdade.
No program on its own can fix 500 years of exclusion and inequality. Brazil has a long history, much smaller than China's, but a history of excluding blacks, excluding the poor, excluding the indigenous. And we've had 10 years of this program, so in 10 years, you cannot solve 500 years of inequality and exclusion. But I think we've made great progress, and not only with Bolsa Família. I think one of the great things about Bolsa Família is that it works with other programs. We have programs that strengthen the public education network, or programs that bring children in for medical follow-ups or for vaccination, that bring nursing mothers in for monitoring. We have a program to help us identify and locate families that need professional training, so adults can get access to professional training so they can enter the job market better. Bolsa Família cannot make up for 500 years, but it is showing progress. And in these 10 years, we've managed to ensure that 36 million Brazilians are no longer in extreme poverty. Yes, there's more to do. This program has not and cannot solve inequality by itself. Nothing can. But we've made good progress, and we'll go even further.
Sozinho nem consegue, nada consegue fazer sozinho isso, mas já avançamos muito e vamos avançar mais.
What do you say to the people who think that too much money is being spent on the World Cup and not enough on programs like Bolsa Família?
Tem duas coisas que eu acho que a gente não conseguiu explicar muito bem para a população.
There are two things that I think we haven't managed to explain to our people. First, that the money that's been used for the stadiums is not money from the federal treasury. It's financing, and it will be paid back. It's not money that would have gone to education and health. It's money from the financial system. We have used treasury resources for infrastructure, to ensure that our metros work, to ensure accessibility, and to complete projects that today, on the eve of the Cup, have actually caused big problems because they're such large projects. They will help improve the transport systems in Brazil, but before they're ready, they disrupt the urban environment. Brazil needs those investments. We need roads, we need ports, and the investments we are making in airports is strategically very important. Today, Brazil's middle class and Brazil's poor, who have never traveled by plane, are traveling by plane. Our airports are congested, and the need to improve them for the World Cup has given us an opportunity to anticipate those investments.
Viaja de avião. Nossos aeroportos hoje estão congestionados, precisam melhorar, e a Copa tem sido uma oportunidade para que a gente antecipe todos esses investimentos.
Another big event happening in Brazil later this year are the elections. And not all Brazilians are content. So do you think that your government has not been able to properly convey the progress that has been taking place over the last few years?
Acho que a grande maioria da população está satisfeita.
I think the vast majority of the population is satisfied. Is being satisfied enough? Do we think everything we've done is enough? No. I think President Dilma said something in Davos that I think is very important. Everything we do only shows the beginning. So every time we have an accomplishment, we have yet another beginning. We are a country that still needs to include millions. So Bolsa Família is only a start. We took millions out of extreme poverty, but people want access to things that are their right, not just income. Young people want more university. People want more access to health care. They want more hospitals, more doctors. So not being satisfied does not mean we are not on track. It means that people want more, and I believe they are entitled to more. Our hope is that we reach our goals and ensure we can give them more.
O povo quer mais e eu acho que tem direito a mais. Tomara que a gente dê conta de alcançar e garantir que isso aconteça.
It seems like there's a place for women right now in Brazil. Your president is a woman. The president of Petrobras is a woman. And you're a woman leading the fight against poverty. What do you see as the future for women in Brazil?
Eu acho o seguinte, que a gente está conseguindo mostrar que as mulheres podem tanto quanto os homens.
Here's what I think. We're showing that women can do just as much as men. Some people say, oh, women are more sensitive and therefore better leaders. I don't think that's what's important. I think what's important is to give the right message to our children, to our girls, our daughters, our granddaughters, to look and say, we have a woman president who can be a good manager, who some say is tough, who is demanding. How great to be able to show that women can be ministers, women can be president, doctors, engineers. We can be whatever we want. I think that's what our girls are learning, which is, I'm so glad I was born female. I can do everything men do, and on top of it, I can still be a mother, I can still breastfeed, and in that sense, I can do more than men. But in the economic sense, and in the professional sense, we can do just as much, and that's the great thing we're seeing.
Minister, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Bolsa Família has inspired more than 20 countries, including Mexico and Chile, to adopt similar programs. Still to come, another program that's a success in Brazil, Flames of Passion on the screen.